Hello, class. Today we are going to cover how we would prepare a vertical exchanger for maintenance, including shutdown cleaning, isolating energy, and blinding. First, let's discuss how a vertical heat exchanger slash steam generator works. The process flow diagram, PFD, shows a typical arrangement with two parallel vertical heat exchangers in a steam generating surface. Hot oil is cooled in the tube side of the exchangers. This is also called the channel side. The oil is on the inside of the tubes. The exchangers are typically floating head exchangers with straight tubes to facilitate cleaning and replacement. The exchangers frequently have multiple passes that must be drained before the exchanger can be turned over to mechanical crafts for cleaning and maintenance. Pass drains are provided to drain trapped oil from each pass. This configuration is used in pump around circuits on coker and fluid catalytic cracking units. The hot oil enters the exchangers in the 500 to 650 degree range. The oil temperature leaving the exchangers will typically be a couple hundred degrees cooler than the inlet temperature. The exchangers might produce steam in the 100 to 600 PSIG range. The water side of the exchangers is the shell side. The water is on the outside of the tubes. Boiler feed water enters the system at the steam drum, which is the high point of the system. The water moves to the mud drum, which is the low point of the system. Water travels from the mud drum to the lower shell side of the exchanger. Water partially vaporizes in the exchanger, which lowers the average density of the fluid in the shell. The lower density fluid rises to the steam drum, where steam is disengaged and leaves the drum. These exchangers operate in parallel on both the oil side and the steam side. One exchanger can be removed from service while the other remains in service. Removing one exchanger might require unit rate reductions to accommodate reduced cooling depending on the unit. Let's talk about how we would isolate the exchanger and remove it from service. Let's assume we are going to remove E2B from service. It is very important to always isolate the hot side of an exchanger first. In this case, the oil side is the hot side of the exchanger. If the water side was isolated first by closing the shell side valves, hot oil would still be flowing with no outlet for steam. The exchanger would continue to vaporize water into steam and potentially build high pressure on the shell side. Notice that there are no safety valves on the shell side, which is not uncommon. There is a potential to overpressure and rupture the shell. A shell rupture could result in a release of hazardous materials on the tube side, vapor release, and fire. Keeping in mind that we must isolate the hot side first, we will block hot oil to the tube side first. It is best to close the valve slowly to minimize thermal shock to the system. Block the tube side outlet when the inlet is closed, then immediately open a pass drain to the drain header for thermal expansion. Heavy oil circuits like the one being discussed contain oil that can set up or solidify at room temperature. This heavy oil must be flushed from the exchanger with a lighter stream. This lighter stream is sometimes piped directly to the heat exchanger, as shown in this process flow diagram. Open the flush to the exchanger and allow it to flow through each pass drain. Block in flush oil when done. Sometimes pass drains must be rotted to establish flow because they can plug over time. The water side is isolated after the tube side is isolated, flushed, and opened to the drain header. block the boiler feed water in first. It is important to have a relief path open to prevent pressure build in case tube side valves leak. Open the blowdown part way to verify flow. Open the blowdown immediately and all the way once the shell side outlet valve is closed completely. Allow the shell side to drain. With the shell drained and vented, the next step is to clean the tube side. This is normally done with 100 psi g utility steam to a safe location. The safe location might be the drain header, depending on your plant's configuration. When the tube side is clean, normal practice is to isolate and lock out all energy sources and steam to the atmosphere before blinding. Blind locations for E2B include the following points: boiler feed water, steam, blowdown, hot oil, cool oil, flush oil, the three pass drain lines, the boiler feed water bleeder, plug and tap it, or tag it, and then the steam bleeder, plug and tag it. The bleeders on the boiler feed water line and steam line are special situations. The bleeders are inside the blind location. Someone entering the shell depends on nobody hooking something up to those bleeders that could harm them. To prevent accidentally hooking up a hazardous energy source, the bleeders are closed, plugged, and tagged as energy isolation devices. Energy isolation points for E2B include the following: boiler feed water, steam, blowdown, hot oil, cool oil, flush oil, three pass drain lines, three pass drain lines on E2A, and the drain header main line. There are more energy isolation points than blind points because the drain header must be isolated at three points on E2A and at the unit limits before the unions under E2B can be safely disassembled. A copy of the blind list and energy isolation list for this job are shown at the end of the video.